I'm about to lose it here today.
All right, we'll see if we can do any better. Well, thank you, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. Today, we're going to be looking at the market real estate numbers, obviously, for the greater Phoenix metro market, ending today, June 8th, for the last week. And then we'll compare not only the month of May, Mike, but we're going to also take a look at how the COVID numbers are working or not. And so across the board for today, we have 49 days closed on market over the past week, a 1.57 month supply. 42.12 is our absorption rate, and our average list price is $597,000. That jumped about $30,000 over the last couple of weeks. Our average sale price at $352,000, almost $353,000, and our list price to sale price retention. This is another talking point today. 99%.
Wow, that's up.
So we're gonna have a conversation about that. Active inventory has continued to drop. 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, actually, active inventory was over 14,000. As of today, it's 13,437. Our pending is up significantly. The people are back, 5,931. And our closed units month to date is only 3,218. Taking a look at the active list, new listings taken, there were 1,721 new listings taken this past week. Our average days on market is 147 for the entire MLS inventory, and our average closed days on market is at 46 days. Taking a look at our price ranges in the bottom right-hand corner, we can see that these under 500,000 market, Mike, this has dropped again. It's back under 70 at 67%. Normally, the housing market under 500,000 represents about 72% of our entire MLS. So when it's down to 67, it's telling, or under 70, it's telling us that something's happening in the marketplace, and we need to really take a look at that. 21% is where we are from 500 to $1 million, averaging 101 days on market. And of course, over $1 million is still hanging on to about 10% of the entire market. But look at that, 195 average days on market. But I want to, you know, just bring out a couple of quick things. The $1.2 to $1.5 million market right now is hovering at about 98 days. So it's really, really quick. And then the moment we get over 1.5, you get into that 235-day market. So consequently, if you are playing in the luxury market, you will see those higher priced homes be very slower as far as sales are concerned. And that's kind of commensurate. It's not new. It's just that's what the numbers are doing. Okay, so taking a look at our slides this morning, our comparison sheets last week or a couple of weeks ago, last time I was on, we did 1,721 was the new listings we took. Last week, we took 1,777, just a little bit more. A year ago, which is that gray shaded section right in the middle, this is last year, same week, we took 2,183 listings. So you can see that that's basically down still. About 20%, just under 20%, 18.6. Taking a look at our active inventory, again, two and a half weeks ago, we were at 13,400. We're sitting at 11,216 right now. These are, the entire inventory. We were at 16,600 a year ago. That's 5,000 more properties. As far as single family detached is concerned, it represents 8,700. And 3 weeks ago, we were at 10,600 almost. So again, a significant drop. What we're seeing is obviously that the drop in the under $500,000 price range is really caused because that's what people are going after right now. The pending are mostly properties under 500,000. New homes also took a drop of about 12%, almost 13% from 1,784 to 1,555. That's the new home inventory that's listed in the MLS. So not obviously the entire MLS, the entire new home inventory. Pending right now, this is another one, jumped 15.3%. So what we're saying is we were averaging 5,931 average properties in escrow during a week. And that was 3 weeks ago. Last week, we jumped up to 6,839 average in escrow. A year ago, here's the silver lining, 6,289. So what does that mean? We were at 6,289 average pending units a year ago. What do we have in inventory right now? 6,839, not in inventory, but in pending, 6,839 units. That's a huge jump. And that's one of the reasons why the inventory isn't keeping up. Skipping the closed this week because it's just a little too early in the month to really extrapolate anything that's happening there. Taking a look at our month's supply, we went from 2.29 months supply, which was very comfortable as far as the buyers in the market versus the number of properties that were available. Now we're down to 1.57 month supply again. Now, don't get too surprised. We'll see that back in April we were at 1.68. So again, the 2.9 last month we ended at 2.3. So it was very, very comfortable from that perspective. But when we go over 50% absorption, that means we're eating up more than 50% of our inventory every month. It's critical. Maybe we're thinking as realtors that sellers don't want to sell right now, but what a super time for people to sell if they can find the home they want, meaning to move to that domino effect, that next upgrade, or maybe if it's a senior population down. But what happens is, 63% for last week. This just means that we're not replacing it. So we've got to be willing to knock on some doors and talk to some sellers and put them in the marketplace. Help our inventory situation out. Our average sale price, were 352 less this past week, 261 a couple of weeks, but that was an anomalous situation. Look to the right. You'll see in last year, we were at 346. We're at 352 right now. That's a, maybe 3.5% increase. So again, that's a really nice place to be. And then of course, our numbers again for our active sitting at 148 and our active days for sold is sitting at 49. That's slowing up just a little bit. The topic here though is the list price to sell price retention, Mike. So what that's basically saying, 99% means the seller's giving up basically 1%. They normally give up 2.2%. So the sellers are starting to not negotiate off the list price. So we'll have to kind of pay attention to this one over the next couple of weeks. So we're going to look at our May inventory. We're going to kind of just compare it to the month before. May inventory, we ended up with 9,298 total new properties added. A year ago, we were at 11,001. That's a difference of about 17%. And again, if you take a look at April, we added 92. It was still in that threshold. But the concern is that if April versus April the prior year was about 15%, we're almost 17%. So we're kind of going in the wrong direction there. Inventory that was 20,000 last year is 16,006. We ended the month at 16,700. So that was down 20%. And again, that's similar. The silver lining here is that's less of a drop than it was the month before. Taking a look at pending is we closed the month at 6,740. That was, we thought was pretty strong. So in April, we were at 4,762 average pending. The problem here is that this is one of our briskest times of the year, meaning we sell more homes during this month and next month than we do basically throughout the year. And so the issue was,
Susan, we thought you said brisket and she's getting hungry.
So we were at, welcome, Susan. So we were at 10,246 last year. We're at 6,740 this year. Basically, what we're saying is that's a 34% drop. So again, it's not. We shouldn't have that much of a drop. I mean, that's ridiculous. But again, we're looking some of these numbers for May. Please keep in mind, these are reflective of the business 30 days, 45 days prior, because, closed inventory is the result of business done 30, 45 days ago. Pending is the result of right now. Point in time, this is what's happening. So that's how we compare these two. So looking at closed units for the month of May, we closed with 7,034. Last year, we closed with 10,527. That's a drop of 33%. Last month, we had a drop of 26%. So basically what we're saying is May's numbers were certainly reflective of the low consumer confidence in the marketplace, even though the rates were dramatically low. And then finally, coming down to our statistical part, we ended the month at 2.37. What a month supply. What a nice month supply that is. Again, closest to three is what our objective is. 1.94 is where we were a year ago. So that was a really good sign, but it is indicative of the slowing number of closed units. taking a look at price ranges, because this is really, I think, when we're out having a conversation with sellers or we're having conversation with buyers, everybody has this tendency to think either we're you know, they should be able to buy the house for 10 or 20% off right now because of COVID, or they think that we're in an inflammatory market where, you know, prices are just unrealistically high. And both of those are incorrect. So if we take a look at these historically over time, you know, we're sitting with our average list prices about $593. They were $653 last month on average, about $570 last year. So not a real huge increase, about 9%. You know, we took a look at average sale price, which is $369,451. Last month we were at $377. So even though the market, there's more people in the market today, and they're buying more homes, it's not putting pressure yet on the sale prices. We're not seeing the sale prices push up dramatically over and above that would say to us that we're moving into the incorrect market.
Well, and I think the number there that pops out to me is when you take a look at the average sales price in the month of May compared to the month of May in 2019, it's right up 8%. So it's good fodder. It's good ammunition to use for your clients that are still sitting on the fence waiting for the market to burst and all these prices have dramatically, you know, come down. Well, we're up 8% from a year ago today.
Right. And if sellers hold on saying, well, yeah, I want to wait for that peak of the market. The problem is when the market takes a dive, you know, or when the market goes into that inflammatory period, rates go up because the rates have to go up to slow the market down. That's usually what happens. You know, they increase the rates, that puts pressure on people, go, you know, I don't want to pay 7%. You know, so again, it slows the market. And fortunately, we're not seeing that. And that's a good thing. You know, again, as far as just talking about average days on market, 49, 67 days last year, 70 is the perfect storm. 70 days on market, it gives everybody time to have a good selection. You don't get multiple offers, you know, significant amount of multiple offers. So we're at 49, which is exceptionally brisk. And as far as list price to sale price retention, we finished at 98. That's just a little bit above our goal of 97.8. We were at 97 last year. So in other words, the sellers were giving up a little more last year than they're giving up today. But again, it's a good market and it's not really out of control. So taking a look at where you can find us as usual, you can see us on Alexa Flash Briefings. Just go to your Flash Briefings and request West USA Realty Market Analysis. We're on Instagram Television, Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Spotify. And of course, I feel that your best listening opportunity is to go to the YouTube, go to West USA Realty. And the reason is because you'll get to see the slides transition as we're having the conversations. And I do have pointers on there that allow you to understand what I'm talking about and when. So thank you very much for listening. We look forward to talking to you.